Hey, Dustin Vanoy here. Something I discovered pretty recently is that you can actually take structured streams and join to delta tables where the data in the delta table changes. If you're reading from Parquet, that data, once you read it in, is going to be broadcast everywhere and it's not going to change for you as your stream is going. With delta tables, it works differently. Let's take a look. So what I have to test out our lookups against Delta Lake is some streaming code that's reading from event hubs. And we will go ahead and read some taxi data in. We will convert it to JSON and pull out the fields that we care about with the proper naming. And then most importantly here on lines 49 and 50, we are going to join the stream of New York taxi data to our lookup table, which is a delta table. So the stream is running right now. I'll start producing some data. And what we'll see is that lookup location 2 is missing from the data. Queens is missing from the data. So we can see that PU location ID 1 is populated. PU location ID 2 is not, because 2 does not exist in our lookup table right now. So with that, let us go and add a record. Okay, I've defined a Delta Lake table taxi zone 1 already, and I'm going to insert into it. So I'm going to insert PU location ID of 2, which is Queens. All right, it says it impacted one row. Let's just double check that if I pull everything from my table, all the way at the bottom, I'll see Queens. And I guess to be more specific, we're talking Jamaica Bay. Okay, so now that we made that change, I'll produce some data again. And as I look down at the bottom, I can see that we now have Queens, Jamaica Bay populating, whereas before it was null whenever the location ID was 2. So that's how we take a stream and join to a delta table and make changes to that delta table without having to restart our stream to get them. Hope you found that tip helpful. See you next time.